Welcome to the final track for Guided Meditation Treks Vipassana. By this point, you have learned and practiced the different modes of bodily awareness through breathing and Vipassana. This final part, called Mettapana, or Loving Kindness, is a short practice you can perform at the end of each meditation. It is a way to reset your mindset to a positive one and spread this joy to others. I firmly believe in Mettapana to help make the world a better place. But even on our own, as we practice loving kindness, it will make our own personal world a better place. We co-create the universe with our perception and thoughts, so what better way to frame our universe than to start each day from a place of loving kindness? Metta is something that you can do for 2 to 5 minutes at the end of your meditation. All you need to do is bring yourself to a position of loving kindness. To do this, you might start out from a position of gratitude, thanking the universe for all that you have for which to be grateful. This will bring your mindset to a place of joy without even trying. Then the next step is to set an intention to spread your joy. This could be through an intention to share compassion. Another example is to set intentions for unconditional love and giving. Unconditional giving is the idea of giving to others without expecting anything in return. Unconditional love is similar. When you give unconditional love to another person, you are wishing them the best for their higher self and their greatest good to the infinite creation, which stretches well beyond your ego. As Goenka used to say, there is no passion in love, only compassion. It is okay to unconditionally love someone who doesn't love you or care for you. Sometimes they need it the most. That said, it is best to love without an intention that you will ever receive in return. As you develop your Vipassana practice and your Mettapana practice, you will become so overflowing with love and joy that you will have nothing else better to do with it than share it and spread this joy and love to others, but in a way that is not selfish or accounting. Loving kindness is something that exists infinitely and with abundance, like the sun. It can be created with something as simple as a thought, and this is really all there is to Mettapana. It's a great way to end each meditation session. I hope you enjoyed the Guided Meditation Treks Vipassana series. Feel free to go back through the parts to fine-tune your practice, but in the end, once you learn the practice, you won't need these recordings at all. Vipassana will simply become a part of your daily practice, and you will develop your own routine that works for you. For me personally, the thing that helped me practice more regularly was simply to practice twice a day instead of only once a day. I actually found it easier to meditate twice a day than once a day. I practice as the first thing after I wake up and the last thing before I go to sleep, and I always know, no matter what happens, this is how I will start my day and end my day. Whereas meditating only once a day, it was easy to shift it around and sometimes find an excuse to not meditate at all. As I write this meditation, I have now been practicing Vipassana twice a day for over 9 months straight. This is definitely my record for consecutive days as well as the time spent in meditation. And it was not hard at all. It's only practice. They say that practice makes perfect, but the fact is, practice is perfect. As long as you are practicing, that's what's important. It's not about the destination, it's about the journey. Take care, enjoy your practice. Peace be with you.